يجيبني حين أناديه ويستر علي كل عورة وأنا أعصيه ويعظم النعمة علي فلا أجازيه نحمده ونسبحه ونقدسه على آلائه ونعمائه ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إلها واحدا أحدا فردا صمدا قيوما نؤمن له بالربوبية ونقر له بالعبودية من يهدي الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا ونشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد
أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك وترحم على محمد وآل محمد كأفضل ما صليت وسلمت وباركت وترحمت على إبراهيم وآل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد وصل اللهم وسلم على جميع الأنبياء والمرسلين والأوصياء والصديقين وعترة نبيك الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين والأخيار من صحابته المنتجبين ومن تبعهم بإحسان وإيمان إلى يوم الدين عباد الله أوصيكم وأوصي نفسي بتقوى الله ولزوم أمره أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والسابقون الأولون من المهاجرين والأنصار والذين اتبعوهم بإحسان رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه وأعد لهم جنات تجري تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها أبدا ذلك الفوز العظيم صدق الله العلي العظيم Understanding the Holy Quran and the meaning of the Holy Quran requires a great deal of reflection and meditation and tafakkur and tadabbur, pondering. And therefore maybe a word sometimes and sometimes a letter in the beginning of the sentence could change the meaning of the verse of the ayah. This is ayah number 100 in Surah Al-Tawbah, and some people asked me about its meaning, the meaning of this ayah, and the application of this ayah, and the implications of this verse. وَالسَّابِقُونَ الْأَوَّلُونَ مِنَ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ وَالْأَنصَارِ Allah says those, the pioneers, السابقون, from the community of the Muhajirun. Muhajirun were in Mecca originally and then they did Hijra. They were transferred to Medina. Ansar are the helpers who were originally from Medina. And وَالَّذِينَ those who followed them, اتَّبَعُوهُمْ بِإِحْسَانٍ not anyone who follows them. Those who followed them with kindness and piety and wholesomeness. بِإِحْسَانٍ those people رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَرَضُوا عَنْهُمْ Allah is pleased with them and they are pleased with their Lord and He prepared for them جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي تَحْتَهَا الْأَنْهَارِ He prepared them paradise with streams overflowing in paradise خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا أَبَدًا they have a perpetual Eternal life, ذلك الفوز العظيم. Indeed, that is the great salvation and a great success. Undoubtedly, the Holy Quran praises some of the companions of the Prophet who were loyal to him right to the end. Among them is Al-Badriyun, those who were martyred in the Battle of Badr. Among them, Al-Uhudiyun. Those who were martyred in the Battle of Uhud, those who were martyred in Mu'ta, in other battles, who gave their life to defend كلمه التوحيد, monotheism, the message of the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and the holy Quran and the Muslim but this verse, I want you to pay attention that this verse does not include all those who were with the prophet. والذين اتبعوهم, first of all, the verse says والسابقون الاولون من in Arabic literature here للتبعيث. Men means, in English, it means among those. So not all, among them. This is number one. And it is conditioned, paradise is conditioned. The satisfaction of the Lord is conditioned by the term بِإِحْسَانٍ وَالَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوهُمْ بِإِحْسَانٍ. Otherwise, if all are included, there is no need for the Quran to say بِإِحْسَانٍ. The ihsan becomes extra, useless. But there is no word, no single letter in this book which is useless. Every single letter, let alone a sentence or a word or an ayah, every single letter has a use and has a purpose and has a meaning. Allah says, "Bi ihsan." We don't grant paradise just for the sake of you being next to me, or sitting in the mihrab, then go to paradise. In the Christian tradition, if you ask the Catholics, they tell you that by merely knowing about Jesus, knowing about him, hearing about him, that will grant you salvation to paradise. By only knowing about him. Others, they say, no, you need to love him too. You love him. But whether you follow him, you don't follow him, that's something else. The love of Jesus is the recipe for salvation. We say love is not enough. Even the love of God is not enough, let alone the prophet. Even the love of God. Someone says, I love God, but he's a criminal. He kills, he steals. Is he going to go to paradise? We have many people, many Muslims who say, I love God, therefore I don't pray. When you ask him, why don't you pray? You're not praying 5 days. He says, Sayyid, come on, Sayyid. I love God. God is in my heart. God is in his heart, but he's not willing to listen to God. Like some husbands who tell their wives, we love you, but he really does not help her. He only loves her, but he's not willing to spend, to help, to be with her. So love is not enough. The real love, it means you follow. You follow. When you love someone, you follow. If you love them, قُلْ, and this is a verse, this is, I'm not authoring something new. This is a verse in the Quran. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي. You claim that you love God. Then if you claim that you love God and you are right, you are right in this claim, فَاتَّبِعُونِي, follow me. The Prophet says, follow me. So following the Prophet is important. Not just being with him or around him or his friend or his companion or merely praying behind him. These are not enough. وَالَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوهُمْ بِإِحْسَانٍ. This is point number one, my friends. This is halt to this point. So those righteous companions are those who follow the Prophet, follow his footsteps. They follow his instructions. Instructions. They do not disobey him. The second condition to go to paradise is to continue the journey of faith. Some people, they started their life on the right track, but then later on they shifted away. Allah says, Husnul Aqibah. Husnul Aqibah means the good ending, the good closure at the time of death. Were you mu'min or not? Some people, they are mu'min for 7 years. At the time of death, he dies, wa huwa kafir. This is not me, huh? This is again the Holy Quran. Allah says in the Holy Quran, some people believed in the Quran, believed in monotheism, in tawheed, in the message of the Prophet, but then they chose to revert back, to change their direction. In Surah Al-Imran, Allah says, وَاَعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبِّ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا وَاذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ إذ كنتم أعداء فألف بين قلوبكم فأصبحتم بنعمته إخوانا. After that he says, O Muslims, ولا تكونوا كالذين تفرقوا واختلفوا من بعد ما جاءهم البينات. Do not be like those before you. When they received the bayinat, the book, the clear signs, they decided to shift away, to change their direction. تفرقوا واختلفوا من بعد ما جاءهم البينات وأولئك لهم عذاب عظيم. And then Surah Al-Imran says, يوم تبيض وجوه وتسود وجوه. On the day of judgment, there are two colors, bright and dark. Bright colors, تبيض, shining faces. Some faces are shining. Other faces, however, are darkened. وتسود وجوه. This is the vocabulary of the Holy Quran. وتسود وجوه. So why تسود وجوه? What happened to them? Why their faces are dark? Listen to the reason. فَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ اسْوَدَّتْ وُجُوهُهُمْ أَكَفَرْتُمْ بَعْدَ إِيمَانِكُمْ. Very interesting. Not that they were their entire life kafir. No, they were mu'min, believers, but they chose to reject the message later on, to shift away. أَكَفَرْتُمْ بَعْدَ إِيمَانِكُمْ. Do you reject faith after you accepted faith? You changed your mind, you reverted. And this is exactly again in the same chapter, وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ. Now, sometimes people say this is too general, this verse. Allah says, if this is too general, I'm going to give you something which is very specific. Very specific. So you understand the application. وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ أَدْخَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرُّسُلُ أَفَإِنْ مَاتَ أَوْ قُتِلًا قَلَبْتُمْ عَلَىٰ أَعْقَابِكُمْ. In قَلَبْتُمْ عَلَىٰ عَقَابِكُمْ, take this sentence, you went back on your heels. It means you reverted, you changed your direction. Put it next to أَكَفَرْتُمْ بَعْدَ إِيمَانِكُمْ. You reject kufr, rejection of tawheed, rejection of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we said last Friday, when you listen to the Prophet, you are listening to God. God says, this man Muhammad does not represent himself, he represents me. Don't take him personal. Muhammad has no personal relationship with anyone. Muhammad, وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ, is nothing but a messenger of God. He represents God. So if Muhammad one day he fights with someone, it means God is fighting with that person, not Muhammad. Muhammad is Rasul in his capacity as the messenger of God. Therefore, some people they're going to reject. Now, if some of those Muhajirin and Ansar, they were extremely good and kind and righteous and pious, but down the road they changed their direction. Still paradise is it prepared for them? Definitely it's not. Not only not for them, Allah says, you Muhammad, you if you change your direction, I will take you to hell. In the Quran, about the Prophet. وَلَقَدْ أُوحِيَ إِلَيْكَ وَإِلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ. Allah says to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I have sent a warning, not just to you, to Musa, Isa, Ibrahim, Nuh, all the messengers. وَلَقَدْ أُوحِيَ إِلَيْكَ. Verily, وَلَقَدْ, when God wants to say something important, he brings وَلَقَدْ, verily. We sent statement to you and to those who before you. لَئِنْ أَشْرَكْتَ, if in case you change your direction. Shirk, you change, you quit your job. After believing in God, you say, today I wake up in the morning, God does not exist. I don't want to work for God. لَئِنْ أَشْرَكْتَ لَيَحْبَطَنَّ عَمَلُكَ وَلَتَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. All the good things that you did for 30 years, 40 years, 50 years, it's going to burn out. لَيَحْبَطَنَّ عَمَلُكَ. حَبْطُ الْعَمَلُ, it means when the work goes in vain, it burns out. We destroy all your work, your past work. وَلَتَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. Tell me, who's greater than Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this universe? Who's greater than? No one. Only Allah is greater than the Prophet. Now if Allah speaks with this language, to his sweetheart Muhammad, and he says to him, if you change your direction, if you commit a sin, I will burn you and burn your work. He would not say to the Sahaba, to ordinary people, they will be granted immunity even if they do something wrong. Jannah is guaranteed for them. Here we have to incorporate something here. We have to bring something called aql and mind and understanding to understand the Holy Quran. Here, when we read the Quran, we have to use the aql. If you put the aql aside, Quran is going to be very confusing. Very misleading, not just confusing. The Quran says, for those who use ulil albab, I'm very bright and very open and very easy. But for those who don't use lob albab, aql, I'm very confusing and misleading. The same book becomes misleading. So we need to incorporate aql when we understand the Holy Book. Allah says there is no unconditional guarantee for paradise for anyone, including Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, including Ibrahim and Muhammad. No unconditional guarantee for them. Yes, paradise is guaranteed as long as they uphold monotheism and faith and Imam. 1 minute, if they decide to do shirk, to exercise shirk, to disbelieve in God, they lose everything. They lose their credit. They lose their credit. We do this here. We do in our daily life. We do this. If someone does good for 50 years, all of a sudden he commits murder. He commits murder and he does not want to repent. He loses his past work. Nobody will employ him. Nobody will trust him anymore. You can't say, but 50 years of good work, 50 years of good work ended in terrible crime. Allah says paradise is for those who continue the journey, my friends, who continue the journey of Islam and faith and commitment and piety right to the minute and the second of death. If they continue this, definitely paradise is guaranteed for them. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد وأهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين